Confession time. I was lolling on my bed, reading a book. This was Jane Vanier's The Search for Signs of Intelligent Life in the Universe. Instead of doing what I'm supposed to do, working on the scripts of my videos and the content of my workshop. And as I laughed and cried my way through it, I never expected it to give me direction for this video. I was doing one of those things that I always tell my clients never to do. Multitasking. Well, the book was open. I was reading and I had the phone stuck to my ear, listening to a friend who was going on and on and on about how she had put on weight again and how her boss insulted her again and how she had the worst job, the worst mother-in-law and how she was stuck in the worst traffic, yada, yada, yada. When suddenly this line jumps out at me. I personally believe we developed language because of our deep inner need to complain. Funny lady, Jane. Got me to talk here, right? And this is what we are going to talk about here. Complaining, the world's favorite pastime. Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumiere 24. Light on. So, why do we complain? Mainly because the world isn't how we like it, right? Believe it or not, on an average, we complain about 30 to 50 times a day. And most of the times, we have no awareness of this fact. Slowly, complaining becomes a habit. A lot of people ask me, what's wrong with complaining? I'm only venting. It's relaxing. Well, complaining is tempting. And it feels good for a moment because like most things enjoyable, like eating that cheese-filled burger or smoking, it isn't good for you. Don't take my word for it. Research from Stanford University has shown that complaining shrinks the hippocampus, an area of the brain that is critical to problem-solving and intelligent thought. Now, damage to the hippocampus is scary, especially when you consider that this is the primary brain area destroyed by Alzheimer's. Now, I'm not exaggerating when I say complaining causes brain damage, but it doesn't stop there. Complaining keeps your focus on the negatives and in a perpetual victim mode. And you know this, what you focus on grows. So you're stuck in a spiral of negativity, anger, and blame. Thinking crap thoughts, speaking negative words, and making you a giant, living, breathing crap magnet. And as you speak and think, your body is listening too. Constant complaining leads to stress and the release of my favorite stress hormone, cortisol, leading to a lowered immune system, making you susceptible to frequent colds and coughs, high BP, diabetes, obesity, and even strokes. And since we're social animals, we don't even have to be huge complainers ourselves to start with. When in the company of chronic complainers, by a process called neuronal mirroring, we automatically pick up the habit. Much like being in the company of smokers, passive smoking and passive complaining both can kill you. Now that I've scared you sufficiently, you will agree that breaking this habit of complaining is not just important, it is absolutely necessary. So let me give you a fun tool from Sheila's toolbox. This one is what I call the KPK, the karma penalty kick. So here's the deal. Get a biggish bell jar or any container. Don't complain you don't have one now. Label it and call it the crib jar. Now, every time you complain, put some money into your crib jar, equal to the price of a coffee. So for every complaint, pay up. And at the end of the day, look at all the money that has been dunked into your crib jar. For a moment, feel the amount of complaints you never even realized you had, and then donate the entire money. That's right, give it away. I don't care to who. Your favorite charity, a homeless person, the donation box in your coffee shop or church or supermarket, give it away. Completely. Every day. no matter what the amount, just give it away. Do this for 21 days. This will not only make you conscious, but will also make you responsible towards yourself. You will notice that you will be more careful before you vent it out, because you are paying to complain. Don't like this idea? Too bad. Tough habits have to die hard. Do it anyway. We have had wonderful response from our various participants who use this method. It's a fun way to do something for yourself, teaching you to live more consciously. Let me also know how it works out for you. I'd love to hear from you. Share this video and tag all the people who have ever invited you to their pity party. Let's spread the light and make our world complaint-free. For more such life hacks, press the bell button next to the video and subscribe. Never miss an update. Ever.